Thank you. The first lesson is taken from the book of Jeremiah, chapter 8, beginning to read at the first verse. At that time, says the Lord, the bones of the kings of Judah, the bones of its officials, the bones of the priests, the bones of the prophets, and the bones of the inhabitants of Jerusalem shall be brought out of their tombs, and they shall be spread before the sun and the moon and all the host of heaven, which they have loved and served, which they have followed, and which they have inquired of and worshipped, and they shall not be gathered or buried. They shall be like dung on the surface of the ground. Death shall be preferred to life by all the remnant that remains of this evil family in all the places where I have driven them, says the Lord of hosts. You shall say to them, thus says the Lord, when people fall, do they not get up again? If they go astray, do they not turn back? Why then has this people turned away in perpetual backsliding? They have held fast to deceit. They have refused to return. I have given heed and listened, but they do not speak honestly. No one repents of wickedness, saying, what have I done? All of them turn to their own course, like a horse plunging headlong into battle. Even the stork in the heavens knows its times, and the turtle dove, swallow, and crane observe the time of their coming. But my people do not know the ordinance of the Lord. How can you say, we are wise, and the law of the Lord is with us, when in fact the false pen of the scribes has made it into a lie? The wise shall be put to shame, they shall be dismayed and taken. Since they have rejected the word of the Lord, what wisdom is in them? Here ends the first lesson.
Thank you. The second lesson is taken from the Gospel according to John, chapter 6, beginning to read at the 52nd verse. The Jews then disputed among themselves, saying, "How can this man give us his flesh to eat?" So Jesus said to them, "Very truly I tell you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you have no life in you. Those who eat my flesh and drink my blood have eternal life, and I will raise them up on the last day, for my flesh is true food and my blood is true drink. Those who eat my flesh and drink my blood abide in me and I in them. Just as the living Father sent me, and I live because of the Father, so whoever eats me will live because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven, not like that which your ancestors ate and then died, but the one who eats this bread will live forever." He said these things while he was teaching in the synagogue at Capernaum. Here ends the second lesson.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Oh,
Let us pray. King of glory, King of peace, who called thy servant George Herbert from the pursuit of worldly honors to be a priest in the temple of his God and King, grant us the grace to offer ourselves with singleness of heart in humble obedience to thy service. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O God, who art peace everlasting, whose chosen reward is the gift of peace, and who hast taught us that the peacemakers are thy children, pour thy peace into our hearts, that everything discordant may utterly vanish, and all that makes for peace be loved and sought by us always. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord and Heavenly Father, who hast given unto us thy people the true bread that cometh down from heaven, grant that our souls may so be fed by him who giveth life unto the world, that we may abide in him and he in us, and thy church be filled with the power of his unending life. Through the same Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Ghost be with us evermore. Amen.